Hello, my friends. Welcome to Trading with KS. So today is a Sunday video, 28th of August. So today we talk about the big picture, and also we talk about the individual sector, and also the individual stock that we talk about the whole week. Okay, this whole week, right? But before that, don't forget to watch this. Yesterday, I got a special edition. Okay, because today video will be very long. If I add in the metal stock, you know, the rebound of metal stock, and also the possible rebound of energy stock, right? So yesterday I made another video in the evening. Okay, so I'm going to spread it out, so you don't get too long a video today. Okay, so check out yesterday video, metal stock and energy stock. Okay, don't miss it. This one also very important. Okay, let's check out the intro first. Disclaimer, be advised that I'm not a professional trader or advisor. I am sharing my trading journey for entertainment purpose only. Any opinions, news, research, analysis, price, or other information contained in this video is my own opinion and does not constitute investment advice. I will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including without limitation to any loss of profit, money, asset, or any valuables which may arise directly or indirectly from use of information in this video. Trading foreign exchange indexes, stock market, futures, commodities, energy, precious metal, etc. carry a high level of risk, and please trade on your own research and assessment. Please seek advice from a professional financial advisor for your trading needs. You won't believe what I saw today. Okay, so today I want to share something that is very, very important that I saw. Okay, we go through the KLCI. Okay, this is what I saw in the KLCI chart, right? Weekly chart. Okay, we check out the small picture first, then I show you the big picture. Okay, what I saw. Okay, so KLCI, remember, okay, KLCI rebound. Okay, went above 1555, which I said is very, very, very important. Okay, resistant. Okay, so it goes through this. Okay, the market short term bullish. After it grow to this 1575, could be a longer term bullish, and could be a start of a bull market. Okay, so the price actually managed to stay above 1575, which is a very good sign. If it went up and came back down, okay, force break, then it's dangerous. Okay, if it does this, came back down, okay, very dangerous. So next week, hopefully, right, it will not come back down. It can stay above 1575, then could be a start of a bull market. Okay, very nice. Okay, but I got something bigger, the big picture. You see this big candle, right? Didn't happen very often. Okay, it only happened, okay, this big candle recovery only happened during two times, which is during the V-shaped recovery last year. Remember last year March, right? Everything you buy go up, right? After the big drop last year of the COVID scare, then the market start to recover, right? During March, right? During almost like April to May, okay? Starting March, okay? March, okay? So market start to recover. The V-shaped recovery I talk about, right? That fail, that we try to get it last during May, right? Okay, during March to May, what was the EMCO now? Yeah, during May, right? Okay, during this time, right, we try to play the V-shaped recovery, right? But the COVID keep on going up, right? The MCO, the government start to say what they want to do, the full MCO, right? Okay, FMCO, which is a fake MCO. This one is a fake. FF means a fake. Okay, it's not a full MCO. So the COVID jumped to 20,000, right? Jumped to 10,000 that time, right? So this one, the V-shaped recovery during this time did not work, right? Okay, so now what I saw, you see, this type of big candle, right, only happened during the V-shaped recovery last year, where everything sky went up sky high, went back up sky high, okay, during this time only, okay, the V-shaped recovery, okay. And also you see this big candle only happened another time, this type of big candle, right, during the second V-shaped recovery last year. Uh Okay, November that time, okay, the RMCO, right? Okay, the RMCO recovery, so only during a V-shaped recovery, okay, a proper V-shaped recovery that work out, okay, only during this time, this kind of, this big candle, weekly candle happen, okay, this weekly candle, this type of big candle, look at this, okay. So this indication should be a start of a new V-shaped recovery that we failed to play last time, okay? Okay, a V-shaped recovery possible, okay? History doesn't lie, okay? And history always repeat itself, okay? So we see the history really, that's why we want to see the chart. We can see the opportunity now, we can see the danger, we can see the sentiment is very bullish, and we can see the history. We can compare the history, okay? We can compare the history to what is going on now, right? Okay, so this indication could be a big bullish recovery coming in, coming soon, okay? And you see, RSI, on the RSI on the, okay, on the weekly already went above, okay, already went above 50, okay, which indication that this is in RSI perspective is a bull market, okay. So as long as the price doesn't drop back below 1575 or 1575 and 1555, okay, it will be a very good market. So okay, so this is what I saw, okay. So okay, you see the daily is like that, okay. So you see the daily, this type of pattern, right, this type of bullish play, only during V-shaped recovery only this happened, only during the V-shaped recovery, okay, only this happened, okay. So let's go to the individual sector first. Consumer, okay, so consumer, we talk about, we got a very big resistance over here at 600, right? So the price already broke through 600, okay, so the price continue go up. So this one, look at this, the resistance is here, okay. You look at the trend line, you look at the trend line, right, the resistance is here, okay. So this one already broke through, so still got some gap to go before it reach the resistance, okay. This one, okay, so the first resistance is here, the next resistance is here. Okay, so it still have, okay, some gap to go towards the next resistance and some gap to go towards the next resistance. So there is a window over here, okay, for the, okay, for the consumer to continue to go. So consumer is okay, it's a sector that is looking bullish now. Okay, KLCI is bullish, consumer look bullish. Okay, so this is both confluence. Also so these are the better sector to go in, okay, this is the better sector to go in, okay. So this is good sector, some sectors no good, okay, we talk about it shortly. Construction, okay, construction also broke out, okay, also broke out from this downtrend channel, okay, first indication of a bullish market. And price now is at here, let me see, resistance. Okay, so there's a resistance over here, 1777. Okay, 173. So 168, so price need to go above 168, and hold above 168, okay, sorry, not here, here 167, okay, if the price can stay above here, okay, this one short term bullish, okay, this one already broke up from channel, also look short term bullish, okay, still got some gap, some window to go, okay, before it hit the proper resistance over here and here, okay, so this is still short term bullish. So construction also is bullish, okay, aligned with the KLCI, not bad. Construction also got opportunity. Technology, Now technology is not so good, okay? Technology now we consider is not so good. No doubt it's still on the uptrend, okay? It's still considered on the uptrend, okay? It's still on the uptrend, but now it's consolidating in a sideways pattern, so it's consolidating in a triangle pattern, sorry, okay? So this after this consolidation, it still it can go down or it can go up, but it depends, okay? If it's managed to break outside this triangle, okay, then we will call this bullish also, okay? We'll call this bullish, then we got chance. Now it's still, okay, it's consolidation, it can go, it's 50-50, it can go both way, okay? And it's, if we don't see a bullish push now, not like construction and not like a consumer, you can see the market is pushing it up. This one, no, okay, it's resting, okay, so this one is not to say bad, but not very strong, now it's not very strong, okay? Industry. So industry breakout, okay? Industry also will be very strong. Looks very strong, if we can stay above 195, okay, for the next week, it should be able to continue to go up. So there is a gap over here. Okay, so you see, we talk about this sideways, right? So your stock go up a few day, go down a few day, go up a few day like that, right? But now you really broke up, okay? Now it's trying to stay above 195, but we can continue stay 195, right? This one should be able to continue go up, of course you need to go through 201 first, okay? Once you go to 201 211, so this is short term bullish, okay, provided it can stay above 195, okay, don't fall back, okay? So this one also is short term bullish. So this one also aligned with KLCI, also got chance, also is short term bullish, okay? Okay, property, we got this, okay, we got this channel, right? Okay, so the price broke below the channel, now went back in the channel, it's a false break, right? What happened to false break? Normally the price will go off the opposite way, right? Okay, so this one as the price already go in back into the channel, okay, so this one is short term bullish, okay, also short term bullish. So this one also got chance aligned with KLCI, also bullish, okay, short term. We cannot say long term yet, okay. Let me see here. Okay, once you stay above here 706, I think this one could be short to medium term bullish. Okay, so this one now is also bullish, aligned with KLCI, okay. This one is so good. Technology not so good. Construction, we already talked about it. Telecom. Okay, telecom. Telecom is still in this downtrend channel, okay. Telecom is still in this downtrend channel, so it's not still very strong, but it's having a short term rebound now, short term rebound. But it need to go above 709, then only we can say it's short term bullish. Now it's just a short term rebound, okay. So this is okay, okay. But it has a very big hurdle, a very big resistance over here, okay. It has a very big resistance at 709. If it cannot go through, it might come back down. So this one is a bit higher risk. Okay? Not as bullish. Logistic. Okay, logistic. We talk about this bottom channel. Sorry, this wedge, bottom wedge. Okay? So the price managed to rebound from the bottom wedge, now is going up. So this is short-term bullish also. Okay, logistic also is short-term bullish. Not bad, so also aligned with KLCI. Finance broke up, from this, so finance we talk about here, right? Remember we talk about here, this is a channel, very important channel, right? So it tried to break one time, rebounds down, second time get rejected down, right? We talk about here, right? Okay, possible opportunity, but we did not get the opportunity because all the loan monitoring, all those things, MCO, so the price come back down. Now it properly broke up, Okay, so this one also is bullish, ah. Okay, so finance also looks strong. Okay, bullish play, aligned with KLCI. But it does have a resistance now, a resistance point over here, 1543, so here, right? Okay, if you can stay above 154, okay, that doesn't drop back, this one will continue bullish. If it drop back also, it's a correction. I think after the breakout, a correction is still possible, it's still going up. Okay. Let me delete this one, no more valid. Okay, still got some resistance, but re-broke through. Yeah, re-broke through. Okay, we got resistance over here, already broke through. Okay, so this one also is bullish. As long as stay above 15455, it's still bullish. Okay, so this one also aligned with KLCI also. Okay, better opportunity. Okay, to invest. Okay, Plantation, we talk about Plantation. We need to break inside 6511, right? So the price already broke inside 6511, continue go up, but it got another resistance over here at 8653, right? Okay, so if we cannot break through, it might come back down. So this one have to have a few more days, maybe a few more days gap to play, but then have to be careful. Okay, once after next week, we have to be careful. Okay, this one, if we cannot go through, it might come back down. So if we can go through, then we've got a short, okay, a short term bullish. So this is considered a rebound, a short term rebound. Okay, this is a rebound, not to say short term, rebound. Okay, because it still haven't break through this resistance line. We cannot call it bullish yet. We can bullish trend. This is just a short term rebound. Okay, once you go through, we will see a longer term bullish trend. But this one is short term, is still bullish. Okay, this one still okay. Okay, still okay to play. Okay, until a few more days, then we have to wait and see here. Okay, by next week we will know whether it can go through this one or not. Okay, short term is still bullish. Healthcare is sideways. Healthcare, so nothing much to play. Healthcare, until it can go above 2873, then it got chance. If it cannot go up, then we will not I'm not interested in, not keen in involved in this. Energy, so okay, energy have a rebound. Okay, energy have a rebound. You got this channel over here. Okay, this small channel, it really broke through this small channel, right? But it haven't broke back inside this main channel. Okay, the big channel. Okay, so you need to go back in. Okay, once you go back inside the main channel, okay, this will be okay, buy bottom channel, sell top channel, means the trend will be bullish. Okay, now the trend is still on what we call this a rebound, short-term rebound. Okay, so we have to see whether it can stay above, it can go above here or not. Okay, if it can go above 786, then we will call it a bullish trend. Okay, this one is still short-term. That's why you go in oil now, you have to be a bit careful. Okay, oil also be aligned with remember, you check my yesterday video, I also talked about yesterday video, oil got one hurdle, one big barrier. Okay, in a few more days for it to break. If it cannot break through, it might go down. Okay, so this is higher risk. But still, short term rebound. We cannot say bullish rebound. Okay, you need to go through 786 first. Okay, so this one is not very good. Okay, so you see, this whole week, right? Many sector is good. Okay, we saw this consumer sector is good, technology not so good. Industry is good, okay. Property is good, construction is good, logistic is good, finance is good, okay, and consumer is good. So we don't see so many sector is good. Okay. So unless we got a bull market coming, which is V-shaped recovery, we don't call it bull market first, we call it V-shaped recovery is coming. Okay. So if you want to play, make some real money. Okay, this is the time. Okay, this is the time. Make sure what you want to do, make sure what we want to invest align with KLCI. Okay, so now what we see is KLCI is going up. Okay, so we want to also invest in the sector that is going up. Okay, I already talked about the which sector. Okay, it's possible. Okay, so I'm not saying that the sideways sector is not so good, but you can see, right, if you're holding technology stock, you see it doesn't move much, right? If you're holding consumer stock, okay, I'm sure that you are already taking profit, right? I don't think you are taking profit on technology stock this week, but technology stock you already make money already. It's not technology stock no good, okay? Last few weeks already make money already, okay? So now we want to take a look at the individual stock a lot. So we have to go through very fast, Mfla. So Mfla not really a bullish trend yet not so good to jump in first At least you need to go through 0.815 first Only some pick some bottom. Look at 0.92. It can break through 0.92. Add some, maybe still can go up. It cannot go through 0.92. Take profit Mfla. Oh, 0.815. Okay, Mfla, Suncon, okay, so Suncon picked some bottom, over here, we picked some bottom because of what? Because of this one, right? RSI divergence, so we pick some here maybe, okay, then look at 1.75, okay, go through 1.75, add some, look at 1.8, 2.0, 2.1, if it cannot go through, come back down, okay, maybe you want to cut loss first, okay, so now the price continue to go up after our discussion. MFCB, nothing much to talk about, okay, still in the sideways market, possible, okay, come back, once the price come back to the bottom channel, maybe buy bottom, sell top or sideways, but this one, hardly, I don't see much of opportunity over here, okay, unless the price break above 4 ringgit, okay, hold above 4 ringgit, okay, then maybe got chance, this one, I don't see anything. MFCB, Destiny, okay, Destiny broke out okay, so after breakup not very strong this one a bit dangerous okay, this one a bit dangerous. 0.19, look at 0.19 if it drop below 0.19 maybe want to cut loss so the break is not sustainable Destiny, you have to be careful okay, now it's doing some correction, it's normal after breakout some correction, okay, some correction down be above 1.9, okay, 0.19, okay, it can go back rebound up, okay, if it continue to drop like that, okay, then cut loss first doesn't look very good, doesn't look very strong this Destiny. Okay, so be careful a bit FPI. Okay, so FPI now I think got a channel already. Okay, maybe I really start to have a channel over here. super three line channel. Okay, so this one already too high, okay, too late to chase, wait for the price to come back down. Okay, if you did chase that day, I talk about here, right, 3.035, if you do chase that day, okay, almost take profit already, or you can take profit also, is okay, okay, because almost reached the top channel already, okay. So if you want to play again, okay, wait for the price to come back down, okay, most likely come back down to the bottom channel around 2.7 to 3.0, rebound, then only buy again. Now RSI also overbought, okay. So this one it's best to wait for. If you already in, possible take profit. If you haven't go in, okay, then wait for a correction first. Wait for a price to come back, okay, to the bottom channel first. Harbor. Okay, so Harbor, the price now still doing a correction, okay, so stop loss 0.9940, okay, this one continue to hold, okay, so this one already but it got resistance over here, okay, 1.015, as we already spoken and we already show, right, okay, the top channel here will be the resistance, this one, the previous channel top, okay, you see, what we draw here is very accurate one, the price broke, came back up, retest one time, retest two time, cannot go through, so this one also be a bit careful, okay. So this one, you need to go back inside first, the channel, then we'll look at the top channel, okay. 1.335, maybe 1.35, okay. So if we cannot do it, if we cannot hold inside, go back this channel, come back down below 0.49, cut loss, okay. Temporary cut loss first, Freight. Okay, Freight is trying to break through 0.719, not yet breakthrough, okay, and this channel also not yet breakout, so this one have to wait, okay. So a very important crossing point, as I said, crossing point of these two channel, the big long term channel, the short term channel, so the price haven't go through. Once the price go through, maybe can buy the bottom channel, sell the top channel, okay, buy bottom channel, sell top channel. So I haven't go through yet. WCT. Okay, so WCT is rebound from bottom channel, continue to hold, okay, stop loss 0.5, target 0.66, MIDF. B plus, BP plus only. So BP plus, we talked about the price fly already, if you haven't go in, then a bit too late to chase, so the price trying to correction. If the price come down, rebound again, then only got chance, now if you already rebought one, maybe you want to take profit, okay, if you bought cheap, maybe you want to take profit, the price already on top of overbought, trying wanted to come down, okay, maybe you'll hold another 1-2 days and see, almost near Kananga price. Remember Kananga price, I said, sometimes it's quite high one, they give, okay, so I will give somewhere here, 0.24, so that they already reached 0.23, okay, so 10 cent different around, so up to you, whether you want to take or not. KP property. So KP property went up above 0.9, came back down, so not very strong, currently doesn't show very strong yet. So stop loss remain the same, 0.8, okay, if we can hold above, not 0.8, should be here, 0.775, okay, if we can hold above 0.775, maybe got chance. If we cannot, okay, then maybe, okay, want to let go first, see, there's one support here. Okay, first warning sign is here. Okay, first warning sign, if we cannot hold, first warning sign is 0.83. Okay, if we drop below 0.83, there's a first warning sign that it's not strong as expected. Okay, so this one bit and see, it cannot hold. That's why I said it need to hold about 0.9. Hold means it. Okay, one day is at least 2 days. It's above. Okay, only one day above doesn't consider hold. You see, this one day went back above. Okay. The second day it fall back down, so this one is doesn't mean it can hold, but doesn't mean this one is no chance to go up. It still got chance, okay? Because it haven't reached our stop loss area first, not yet, okay? Still got chance. RSI still above 50, okay? Still okay, still not too bad, But the upward momentum slow down a little bit because Thursday, Friday, okay? Possible, take profit. But the sector is still okay, okay. This sector, construction property sector is still okay. My EG want to go do blockchain, you know, right? You want to do DeFi and blockchain, the cryptocurrency exchange, okay, the bank for cryptocurrency, something like that, If they get the approval, they will be very big for them, So this one we really talk about, buy bottom, pick bottom somewhere here, then add some here, 1.8, target 1.96 and 2.13, okay, now it's consolidating at 1.96, cannot go through yet. Okay, if we can go through, look at 2.13, okay, then you look at whether it can go through. It cannot go through, come back down, okay, maybe cut loss first. If we can go through 2.16, 2.13, then look at 2.65 UOB price, So this one continue to hold, okay. UOB got target 2.65, okay. Oh, here, UOB 2.65, 0138, okay. Breakthrough, pick some bottom, okay. Breakthrough, collect some, okay. 1.96, short term target 2.13, also short term target. If you longer term target, you want to look at UOB, Hexstar. So Hexstar is the top channel, better wait for price come down first, only play, now it's a bit dangerous, too high. Airport. Okay, so airport that day we say, okay, first opportunity go in, second opportunity, now the price is so holding strong, so we are looking at target at 6.7 to 7.155, Petronas gas. So as I said, Petronas gas is so sideways, not too many opportunity, can pick some bottom lah, but have to hold long time. First is 1.6, you have to see whether it can break through or not. Then if it cannot, then you have to look at 1.16, whether 16.5, okay, whether it can break through. If it can break through, you look at 17.2. You look at 17, okay, so if you can go through 17, then okay, you can continue to hold, this one you have to just hold, long term, okay, these are long term, the chart is okay, the chart, what indicate that this one is okay, RSI is above 50, okay, it means it's still slowly, steadily is going up. Pharma. Pharma, the second order 5 million is not so much, so I said wait for, if you are holding it at the 80 cent here, okay, a rebound around near to 1 ringgit or 94 cent other day possible, already can sell, okay, because this one I don't think if you're going like last time fly high, because the order is not very big, for the Sinovac. But they say when they want to go overseas, we don't know, if they got big order from overseas, maybe it still can go, okay, still can fly, but now doesn't look very good, B plus already top. Racing. Racing tech. So racing tech is a bit dangerous, chasing high lah. This one 7232. The price rebound of at the top channel. Maybe still can play until 0.8, but have to be careful. Sub loss have to be tight at 0.63 if you're chasing this. This one is chasing high, very dangerous, as I said. Okay, so there's a possibility the price can go higher, but very risky lah, very risky. The price do break through, okay, do make a rebound over the top channel, so there's a possibility it can go to 0.8. But this one have to be careful. I would not chase this one. Chasing high is not my time. Iconic no power lah. Iconic, just market just doesn't seem to want to, especially the institution doesn't really want to goring it. So it only shocks and delay. So it go up one day, fall down one day. Well, so you see a shock sendiri, it went up one day, one big volume, go up one day, then no support, coming back down. So this one got chance to run first. I'm not keen looking at this. And the price really broke below this push candle already. Means it's very bad. The price need to remain, the best it need to remain above this candle. Okay, to say that this still got chance to go. So already dropped below, so no good this one. Market, just I think the institution not interested, not the same market. The retailer, I think, still interested. Okay, the retail traders, but the institution, I think, not interested. That's why it, after such a big push, all run. Everyone also run only. My news. Okay, my news. Okay, continue to go up. So RHB, okay, target 1.2. So this one, this target spoil the game lah. Kenanga target spoil the game, okay. Kenanga target here, okay. So that's why we didn't go in. We should have go in here for the RSP target, but Kenanga got target here, so that's why we went up. We don't dare to take because even window too small to play at the breakout, okay. But you really broke out Kenanga target. We managed to grab it, continue to hold. Your target will be 1.1 to 1.2. My target and RSP target. Berjaya Food. Oh, very volatile. Berjaya Food reached the target already. 2.25. Okay, but then came back down. Okay, so this one be very careful. Continue to hold. Okay, hopefully it can continue to go up. Okay, but this one there would be a chance. Okay, to take profit at 2.2, but you miss really. Never mind, hold it first. If it really dropped to 1.8855, then have to cut loss. Okay. Opportunity rerun, okay, because this type of stock very volatile one, okay, very volatile. The candle is not very beautiful. All this you have to watch very closely, because opportunity might come a while then gone, okay. So this one, if you manage to capture that one, right, you still got 10%. Remember, hold it first, okay. If it still hold above 2.03, means it's still okay. If cannot hold above 2.03, right, means the first danger already show you that the market, it cannot continue to go. Okay, what's 2.03? Okay, if you want to sell, if you drop below 2.03, I think still okay. But the better one is 1.855. You might sell too early. Genting Malaysia. So Genting Malaysia continue to hold after went up, some correction is normal as long as it stay above this triangle is still okay. Maybank is 3.32 target. Scope. Hey, scope it for the price come back down, rebound only play now is a correction. You see we redraw the top channel, right? It's very accurate. You see we redraw the top channel, right? What happened after the price reached the top channel? Our target, right? So the price come down, okay. So this is the power of the chart. So we saw this before anyone else see this, and we saw where the target before anybody know where is the target. I mean, some chart, of course the institution, the chart people already know similar, because what they're doing is similar to what the institution, most likely what the institution doing. Okay, because they have all the qualified financial advisor which they also study this chart. Okay, they study fundamental, they also study chart, and they have this certified chartist also, right? CTA, certified technical advisor, right? So all these are okay. How they read chart is quite similar to me. I cannot say 100% same, because everyone got their own preference one. Okay, everyone also got their own preference. Or the way you make car, and the way Toyota make car, and the way Nissan make car, they are making the same car, but their car actually is slightly different. Okay, the performance, the spec. Okay, Toyota maybe okay go for something longevity. Okay, and Nissan maybe go for style, you know, this type of thing, like a Mercedes and BMW last time go for speed sport. Okay, Mercedes go for comfort, but now all mixed already. Okay, now all mixed already. Mercedes also got comfort, got sporty. BMW also used to be sporty, now also become comfort. Okay, but still there is still something you can slight different, you can identify one. Okay, so the way the BMW drive, right, it still drive more of a sporty car. Okay, kind of a sporty car than the Benz. But of course the latest one, I haven't tried lah, they don't know lah. Okay, so okay, Josh Ken, okay, I just can have it go up to 0.76, wait for it to go through 0.76 first, or better lah, because there's resistance over here. MIEG already talk about it. LHI. I don't have it. Okay, LSI is still sideways So if you want to go for the HLB target, you need to go through 0.75 first. Go through 0.75, then maybe got chance look at 0.775. Okay, go through 0.705 first. Okay, if you can go to 0.705, then you got chance to go to 0.77. If you can break through, look for RSB, HLB 0.9. If you cannot go through, maybe you want to take profit first. Because there's a big resistance over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times it cannot go through. So if it can go through, it'll be very bullish. IOI Corp. So IOI Corp breakout, okay, above 4 ringgit, okay, can pick up. Target 4.2, 4.5, okay, 4.2, 4.5 first lah. 4.5 the highest, okay, highest is here. Okay, so this one hold it first. But you need to watch 4.2, you need to go through 4.2. If you cannot go through 4.2, maybe you come back down. So watch 4.2 is the important. Okay, so stop loss will be here. If you already go in, your stop loss will be here. 3.7, okay. Put it 3.8 lah, safer lah, 3.86. Okay, if you go through below 3.86, be careful, okay? P meter. Okay, P meter, okay, breakout already hit the first target 5.4, okay, so this one, the next target will be UOB 6.0, 6.5, okay, so this one, but be careful, 4.53, it got a very big resistance over here, okay, it need to break through, if you can break through, then UOB target shouldn't be a big problem. If you cannot break through, it might sideways first, take some time before it go back up, okay, so this one still okay, still okay, but you see, it got resistance over here, okay, resistance over the top over here, which is a 5.4, it cannot break through, for now, this one just continue to watch. TSH. Okay, so TSS, if you manage to buy bottom channel, sell top channel, okay, so this one just wait for 1.15 first, okay, if you manage to buy bottom channel, 0.99, look for 1.15, you can go through 1.15, okay, then maybe you want to try, okay, the higher price, but now it's sideways, a bit difficult to play, not interested for me, okay, sideways market. Asia. So it's just slowly rebound, V-shaped recovery, hopefully this one is a real V-shaped recovery, continue to hold above 0.9, you need to stay above 0.9, if you cannot, then got danger, it might come down, okay, so need to stay. Now it's 0.95, 905, okay, hopefully can stay 0.905, if cannot, then you have to put your stop loss, either you want to cut at 0.79 or you want to cut higher. Oh, but better cut at 0.79 lah. 0.86 also possible. You are short term, you want to cut here. Okay, but better 0.79 lah, or 0.80 lah, put here. Okay, 0.80. IOIPG property. Okay, breakout 1.26, right? You can go above 1.26, can hold. So it went up and came back down a little bit, but still okay lah. This one, okay, not still okay. So your stop loss remain to be here. Okay, 1.135, stop loss remain to be here. Okay, you want continue to hold. It went through, but it come back down. Not very strong. It should have stayed above. Not too bad yet, okay, not too bad yet, okay, at least it haven't come back to test this line 1.185, okay, this one still holds, continue to hold. SP Satir. Okay, buy bottom channel, sell top channel, continue to hold. Time plantation. Okay, this one really broke through. Okay, so continue to hold towards the Nanga target and 4.6 and the public bank target 4.9. Okay, so stop loss remain the same 3.8. M bank. So M bank, okay, continue to hold, break out already. So continue to hold. Genting Malaysia, we talk about it. Airport. Airport, we talk about it. Pesta. Okay, continue to hold, already break out. Okay, so continue to hold. Target 0.735, 0.8, 0.93. The this one look at the yesterday steel video. Okay. Sign. Okay, time this one, okay, went up. Now some correction. So this one pick bottom over here. Remember, pick some bottom over here. 2.2. Target will be 2.5. If you can go to 2.5, continue to hold. If you cannot go to 2.5, maybe you want to take profit first. Okay, 2.5. MSM. MSM continue to hold. The price break up, broke up from the channel, came back down. Okay, consolidating now is at 1.45, still okay lah. Continue to hold, crossover 1.7, 2.0. Remember, put your stop loss 1.295. Drop below 1.295, need to be careful. Kenang, Mr. DIY. So Mr. DIY, be careful. The company, the one of their shareholder, okay, Credo, really throw their stock. So this one I will not play anymore. Okay, because the Credo, the fund, the Credo fund, that support this Credo, they call it the fund, that support this Mr. DIY already start to throw their holding. So very dangerous. Okay, Credo, they call it one of the fund that support this Mr. DIY for public listing one. It's investment house, they call it investment house. Okay, so this one probably don't play. Kenanga. Okay, Kenanga after breakout, we want to be careful. More careful is 1.37. Okay, you need to hold above 1.37, but you cannot. So this one, okay, by right there's no entry. Okay, there's no chance to trade. But never mind, if you already open up, never mind. Okay, continue to hold, because as long as Kenanga, as long as the stock market continue go up, it shouldn't be a big problem. Okay. As long as the stock market continue to run up, so after a big through, there's some correction lah, it's normal lah. So your stop loss, put it here first 1.19. Okay, if you can hold above 1.19, then it shouldn't be a problem, because the price will break out after that. Come back and retest is normal. After a break, come back to retest this broken trend line is normal. Okay, so let's see what happened. KGB. Okay, so KGB already hit this target. Target 1.13 already hit. Okay, now we want to look at 1.13 can go through or not. If you go to 1.13, you can look at 1.35. Okay, so we talk about breakout over here, right? So our target 1.24, 1.35 already reached. So this one, see whether you can go through, you can go through, look at 1.5, you can go through, maybe sell first, because it's very important. Okay, this is the top channel, this is okay, the previous high over here, so this is a very big resistance, okay, very big, very difficult for it to go through. But who knows, maybe it can go through. Echo so Echo already break out, okay, already break out, continue to hold, okay. 0.75 already broke through 0.75, now holding at 0.715, okay, so continue to hold towards 0.755 and possible higher, okay, stop loss 0.655. Bunzak. So Bunzak breakout, okay, it still cannot go through 0.415, wait for it to go through 0.415 only go in, okay. Tenaga. Okay, Tenaga already breakout, okay, this one continue to hold, okay, 10.8, 10.3 already breakout, 10.8, maybe higher, just continue to hold, this one hold long term, okay, hold long term, this one is not a short term, short term play, so already breakout, this one already divergence, RSI, so short, can pick some bottom, maybe 10.3, pick some bottom, okay, add some, okay, continue to hold long term. Nanga retop Pharma Iconic retop. Okay, Kejaya. So Kejaya cannot go through 1.26, okay, you need to go through 1.26, only got better chance, if you cannot go through, maybe just sideways here, look out for 1.26. Maybank. So bank all report, suddenly bank all report profit. So Maybank already break out, continue to hold, okay, continue to hold, 8.6, 8.9, okay, possible target. RL. Okay, I'll pick bottom, 0.54, okay, pick some bottom, then look for 0.59, 0.64, 0.71, and possible above, UOA, development. Haven't break out, okay, RSI divergence, want to pick some bottom, if you break out here, it's okay, then 1.6, break above 1.6, maybe collect some, okay. So you can look for the higher target, 1.73, 1.83, 1.91. Taffy recording already, just wait and see, no point to chase now, recording so high already, so no point to chase. Sign property. Okay, sign property went out, went back inside the channel already, so continue to hold. Okay, stop loss 0.6 towards the public bank 0.79 or my target 0.75. PCAM. So Benelux chemical, so cannot go above 8.455, so this one better don't play, they drop back down, okay, I think some investor kena already, but just continue hold and wait and see. Asia talk already. My news talk already. GCB. GCB or CCB? GCB. Okay, so GCB break up, continue to hold, okay, continue to hold 3.2, 3.4. Malawa. Malover. So Malover break out, came back down, not so beautiful, cannot hold above 0.545, be careful. Stop loss 0.49, this one continue to hold, but be careful. Leong Fat. Okay, Leong Fat haven't break out, look at 1.030, need to go above first. Task. That's okay, bottom channel breakout, RSI above 50, can try, can go in some, look at target 0.425, top channel. Still, okay, re-talk yesterday, ABNB, that was the bank. ABNB continue to hold, re-breakout UOB 2.6, okay, maybe still can go higher, I think. Okay, M-Bank, re-talk about it, CMB. CMB broke out almost to the target, UOB target 5.1, continue to hold. SLB. Okay, buy bottom channel. Bottom channel rebound. RSB. Broke out already, continue to hold. Okay, next target will be here. Here 0.5, 5.6 and 5.9. Public bank. Okay, already broke up from the bottom channel. I went back in the bottom channel, now slowly going up. So target will be 4.4, my target or 4.6 UOB target. Okay, continue to hold. So we got let's see, correct. Amanda is oil. Look at the oil video yesterday. Azata. So Azata rebroke out. Continue hold. Okay. Continue hold towards Kenanga and RSB 4.7 and 4.45. IHS already fly that day. So cannot play lah. Wait and see lah. TM. Too late to chase, I just take a quick look, Oh, already break out too far, cannot chase. So this one supposed to be when? Is it on Friday? So this one supposed to be not included today. Let me see. Yeah, this one is for next week. Sorry. This one is for next week, so. This week we want to talk about this because this one is happened on Friday. No point to talk about because no market didn't change. Okay, so we are supposed to talk until here only. Too many video. CTOS. A lot of people ask about CTOS. CTOS. Suddenly big volume come in. So you guys got follow or not? CTOS. Talk about CTOS, right? CTOS way we want to watch, remember CTOS 1.64. So once you go to 1.64, you get to catch it. So I really label here already. Go to 1.64, you need to catch it. Okay, now really Kenanga target 1.75. Want to hold or not? I'm not sure because this one Kenanga already give target here. Okay, so if you buy now, you really overvalue. Means already over than what the market expected it. The value of the company already over fundamentally higher than what they forecast it is worth So one or don't one is up to you, but you should have called it at 1.64 to 1.75. Okay. Want to hold it long term? I have to wait and see Got some friends ask whether this one can hold for long term. It's still difficult to talk. Still difficult to see with so little data, okay. Chart wise is difficult to see. But and fundamental wise, Kenanga only thing is worth this price. Okay, 1.75. So up to you want to hold or not. Okay, chart wise I cannot see much because it's too not enough data. What I can see, I already told you, 1.64. Okay, above. Okay, can buy towards the Kenanga price 1.64 towards 1.75. Okay, so this one already hit the target. Okay, which I talk about. Okay, which this is the way I would play lah. Already, not much lah. 6%. Okay, you really get 6% around there only lah. So this one long term can hold or not? I'm not sure. Okay, what you want to do is you look at 1.75. Okay, what I would do if I want to chase this lah. Okay, I look at 1.75. If after long time it can hold above 1.75, right? Maybe if you have a chance, means you do something like that. If you do a pattern like that, okay, pattern. Pattern, then it break through again, okay? Just like here, it did a pattern, right? It did a pattern, okay? It break through, okay? So wait for it to do a proper pattern, show us that it really do a flag pattern, a wedge pattern, then it break through. Then maybe we want to go in again. Or now, okay, already reached Kenanga target is difficult. Okay, for me, difficult. KNM. Okay, so can we talk about the breakout over here, okay? We talk about here, right? I show you the breakout over here, opportunity to buy. Now already reached my target 0.265, so don't miss, okay? Don't miss it, okay, 0.265. So, but I still want to hold, okay? There's still possible, it can go higher, 0.31, maybe it's up to you, want to hold or not. Okay, for me, I will take some profit, maybe keep some, okay, see next week. If it come back down, maybe I take profit first. Okay, then if it breaks through, then I buy again. Okay, so this one is a top of the triangle. It's still a very big resistance over here. Okay, as I would say, after I take profit, I would take some of the profit to put it in, see whether it, how far it can go. If lose also, it's not my money. Denko is what? Got some friends ask for Denko. I see Denko not bad at the stock. Oh, so I went to talk. Take a quick look here. Industry. So a lot of comment. Last few days. Yesterday night only I managed to reply because I said this week I'm a little bit tied up. I've got many things to personal things to follow up. So Denko breakout. This one. Okay. This one got chance. Okay. But you have to watch out here. 0.59, okay, if cannot go through, maybe I'm gonna take profit, okay, this one already break out, okay. So RSI also gone above 50 already, volume also got some bigger volume, so this one be very careful, volatile, this one, very small volume, so it can fly very high up and fly very high down, very low down, very fast, okay, so look at 0.595, if you cannot go through, maybe take profit, if you can go through, then you can look for all this, okay, you can look for 0.65, 0.69, and ultimately 0.74. Denounce, I don't know what happened. We got one of our friend OGN. He like to play denounce. Okay, denounce look very very strong. Okay, last week, but suddenly boom, big drop. I don't know what happened. Okay, it hit. Okay, it hit this one, this resistance 0.6, almost hit the top target 0.75, but then suddenly break drop, this one cut loss. So I for me I'll cut loss, and because RSI already dropped below 50 already, means downtrend start already. Okay, if haven't cut loss, better cut loss. Okay, so that's it for today. Hey, remember, right, smash the like button, help me to pump up the like button. Last few weeks, last few days was the like button was very very hot. Okay, so the like went up quite a lot. So try to pump it up for me, because want to make the YouTube know that this is a very interesting channel, that a lot of our followers follow at this one. We got very valuable information to share with everybody. Also, if you are new here, subscribe every week. Every week now, 14 video at least. So every day 7 to 8 o'clock, 2 video, 1 English, 1 Chinese, 7 to 8 o'clock. Every trading day we'll post. Okay, any goodies we'll talk about, discuss. We'll check out the chart, how the stock perform in the chart, and we will come out with a analysis. And also, this is my personal opinion, not financial advice. And also, okay, every week we will give a full review of what we talk, all the stock we talk about the whole week. And also, we look at the big picture, what is coming, what we think is coming next week. Okay, what are the opportunity, what are the danger. And also, now Saturday, we have a special video. Okay, what do you call it? Hey, special edition. Okay, then a lot of things that I miss out or anything that I want to discuss, I'll talk. I put in an extra video on Saturday, special edition. Okay, so stay safe from COVID. Smash the like for me. Bye bye.